Today I'm here to talk about rainwater harvesting. So let us understand what rainwater harvesting is and how it can be useful to us. So rainwater harvesting is basically a technology which is used for collecting and storing water so that it can be used later on for many different purposes. So this rainwater which is collected and which is stored can have many different applications and uses, like it can be used to recharge groundwater, it is used for the gardening purpose, sometimes it can be used for drinking purpose as well, then for irrigation, washing vehicles, even washing for your pets, then refilling the fountains, fish ponds, swimming pool. There are many other ways in which rainwater can be used. Basically, this rainwater harvesting can be done by adopting any of the four different methods. So first method is capturing the runoff from the rooftops. Second is capturing runoff from the local catchments. Third is capturing the seasonal flood water from local streams. And fourth is conserving water through watershed management. So we'll see one by one what all these methods are. So first is roof catchment system. Roof catchment system is when the water is falling on the roof, from there we can get that water and we can save that water in many different ways. And this roof catchment system involves three different things by means of which water can be harvested. So first is the collection surface, second is the storage tank, and third are the channels or the pipes which are called as guttering channels. So these are generally for the transportation of water. This roof catchment system can be done by these many ways. So first is installment of barrels. So barrels are the storage type of thing which are generally used and they are installed somewhere at the bottom of the house or any of the apartment, so that the water which is coming out from the roof will generally find its way towards this barrel. Second is the storage tank. Storage tank is like any other normal tank, where a tank is installed either at the side of the building, or it could be away from the building, but the roof is connected through this storage tank by means of pipes which are called as gutters. Third system is the surface harvesting. So this is the most simplest system of collecting and storing rainwater. So here simply some polythene sheets or something like that is used, where the water which is coming can be trapped and then it can be channelized towards a tank or the storage material. So these are the three basic systems. Now the water which is coming out and it is falling in the roof, generally it is not very fit for use, because it will have many different like particles or contaminated things. So whatsoever system we are installing, that system is having filters. So basically the roof catchment system involves three different type of filters, where first is the sand gravel filter. So this is a filter which is made out of sand, aggregates of stones and particles, followed by pebbles. So when water passes through this system, majority of the particles or any other thing is trapped over here, and the filtered rainwater then can be used. Second are the charcoal filters. These filters are actually having the lining of charcoals, and when water passes through this filter, the resultant thing which we get is a pure water. Third and the most advanced type are the PVC pipe filters. This PVC pipe filters are basically made out of PVC. The pipe is actually made out of PVC, and this filter is having a wire mesh somewhere at the center. This wire mesh is installed to catch all the materials which are present in the rainwater, so that the resultant thing which we get is a pure water. Second is the ground and rock catchment system. So the water which is falling on the ground or the rock, that can be usually stored by this method. So here also three different type of things are involved. One is the collection surface. Here we can see the water which is falling on the surface, that is actually called as the collection surface. Then we install a storage tank. This storage tank and the collection surface is attached by means of guttering or the channels. So in this way, the ground or the rock, the water which is falling over there, can be stored. third are the flood water harvesting. So this is something where huge amount of water can be harvested, and that is why it is also called as large catchment water harvesting system or spate irrigation. So this can be done by three different ways. First is the permeable rock dam. So here the rock system is used to install and to save water. This rock is actually helpful in distributing or spreading the flood water, which can be later on used for irrigation. Second is water spreading bunds. So here the bunds are prepared. In this way, the flood water which is coming, it is actually diverted or it is spreaded, and then it forms a different type of diversions, which are called as diversion drains or diversion channels. This is constructed so that water can be channelized towards the agriculture areas or agriculture land for irrigation. Third are the flood control reservoirs. So this is the most advanced system where a huge amount of water can be taken and it can be stored. So this actually consists of systems where the water can be stored, and it is a self-operating system which is equipped by many different type of equipments. So here it acts as a reservoir as well, and from here water can be channelized to different areas. Fourth is watershed management. So in this method, different type of things are used, where first is contour trenches. So for contour trenches are basically the ditches which are dug in the mountainous area, and this is generally dug which is perpendicular to the flow of water. So what it does is it will trap rainwater, and by trapping rainwater, this rainwater is channelized towards the ground surface. Second are stone bunds. So here the stones are used to form a bund type of system where water can be harvested and they are arrested. So this is something which helps in controlling soil erosion. At the same time, it helps in increasing the groundwater level. Third system is afforestation and field burns. So afforestation means planting of more trees will obviously save water, it will catch water. And second are the field burns. So field burns are nothing but the channels which are built in the fields, and these field burns will help in storing water, and it is also used for irrigation. Fourth are gully plugs and nala bunds. So these are the small stones which are built either in the channels or it can be built in the nalas, where they can just arrest water. Then are the check dams and percolation tanks. So small check dams are built so that they can store and harvest water, which can be used later on. Now this was all about the methods of water harvesting. Now we'll see how water harvesting system is used in India. So long back in Harappan civilization, the first water harvesting technology was used. Then in western Himalayan mountains, they use kul irrigation. So this is nothing but when the glaciers melt, it is diverted by means of kul. Kul is a pipe or the diversion, I should say, where these channels will follow many different kilometers, and then they will fall into a tank where water is stored. In the same way, there are inundation channels which are used in Bengal flood areas. So this inundation channels, they are built near the river which is receiving a huge amount of water. So the flood which is there in the river, that is channelized for the purpose of irrigation. These channels are called as inundation channels or canals. Then Khadims of Jaisalmer. So this is something which was used early in the 15th century, and this is nothing but storing water by covering it through all the areas, and this is generally used for growing crops and all. Then Johars of Rajasthan. So Johars of Rajasthan is nothing but it is a structure which is constructed so that water can be stored for domestic purpose, and it looks somewhat like this. Then tankas of Bikaner. Tankas of Bikaner are constructed inside the ground with a little bit height over the surface. So here the pipes are channelized in such a way that whatsoever water is received by that area, it will go through that tankas. One more thing, like today, Rajasthan is using this Rajasthan canal system, which is developed by Indira Gandhi Nahar project. And this is something which is connecting many different rivers and canals by means of which water can be harvested and it can be used for irrigation purpose. Now, this is the thing which is used in northeastern states, and this is called as bamboo drip irrigation. So, because it's a mountainous area, so bamboos are used as a pipe which is channelizing the water from the mountainous area, and it is going and irrigating the crops. It is not a new technology, rather it's a 200-year-old system of water harvesting. Then the Deccan Plateau. So, Deccan Plateau is something which is the South India. Here, the tanks are installed in the buildings, in the apartments, and then it is used to recharge the groundwater system. So, these tanks can be installed either outside the apartment or at the top, somewhat like this. So, rainwater harvesting is a technology which is having many different advantages. So, basically, it's a very common system, but not very common. So, this is something which is simple to install. Anybody can install it, anybody can be trained for this, and rainwater harvesting system should be used by everybody in every building, every apartment, so that we can save water and it can be used for further applications. Thank you.